So far we have discussed the application of I effect, and in that we have discussed the stability of carbocation. Okay. Now the second intermediate we have, that is free radical. What is free radical? You see, again if I write down this example, three bond pair, and it has only one electron present in this p orbital. Okay, means this electron is not taken away. Okay, it is there in the orbital only. Okay, so now you see here how many electrons this carbon has here. If I talk about only carbon, carbon is four electrons in the outermost shell. So these are the three electrons of carbon which is bonded with X, Y, and Z. Okay, and the fourth electron is present in this p orbital. It is not taken away. It is not withdrawn. Okay, so it is there with the carbon atom. So carbon atom has all its electron present with it. It has no extra electron, and not it has no extra electron present on this. Now it has been, and it did not lose its electron to the other molecule. Right? Four electron of carbon is there with the carbon itself, and that's why this is neutral in nature. Right? All the electrons are present with the carbon atom, and it is neutral in nature. Now you see a few characteristics of this. This carbon atom, which is, you know, a free radical, it is also sp2 hybridized. When it is sp2 hybridized, it is trigonal planar right. When it is trigonal planar, how many electrons it has? See, if I in the bonding state, if I calculate all the electrons, so we have a pair of electron here, a pair of electron here, a pair of electron here, so it has total 7 electrons. So it has total 7 electrons present. Okay, 7 electrons present. It is electron deficient also, less than 8 electron. So it is electron deficient also. Electron deficient, but it cannot accept a pair of electron, right? Because carbon cannot extend its octet. If it accepts a pair of electron, the total number of electron becomes 9, which is not possible. So it cannot extend its octet, so cannot accept a pair of electron, so can't behave as a Lewis acid. Lewis acid. Okay. Now, since it has one unpaired electron present with it, right? It is paramagnetic in nature. Paramagnetic. What is the magnetic behavior of carbocation? See, in the carbocation, we do not have present. We do not have this unpaired electron present over there. We have only these three bond pair with one positive charge on this. So all the electrons are paired over there. Okay, so carbocations are diamagnetic in nature, right? Carbocations are diamagnetic in nature. Free radicals are paramagnetic in nature. Like this, we have, you know, two, three different point or difference between these two. You can keep in mind. Okay, it has no charge on it also. But carbocation has one positive charge. Okay, its stability factor is also same as that of carbocation. Okay, so stability of free radical is directly proportional. Stability of free radical is directly proportional to plus I effect and inversely proportional to minus I effect. So this is what, again, you have to keep in mind here. directly merged into plus one sheet, it is actually same as that of carbocation. Okay, so on the basis of this only, we'll discuss few examples. One example I'll discuss, then I write down the question. You can solve it on your own. Then we'll solve the questions also. Okay, so first example, you see, I'm taking this NR3 and CH3. Again, you see, the difference in the molecule is what? We have this group attached here, and we have this group attached here. Okay, this group, we know it shows minus I, strongly minus I effect it shows. Very strong minus I group. And this one is what? Plus I. Our stability of free radical is directly proportional to plus I, inversely proportional to minus I. Order of stability will be, right? Similarly, you have to solve these questions. I'll just write down here. Okay, so these are the few examples I have written that you have to solve. You can pause it and solve. I am discussing it. Okay? The first compound is this, CH2CH2PH, CH2CH2CCl3. Okay? So which one has more minus I effect? That's the question. Okay? Now you can start. I will start solving this. I am starting this solution of this. So this group that is phenyl here, it has minus I nature, but this CH3 has plus I nature. Electron releasing, electron withdrawing. Stability of free radical increases by plus I nature. Order will be this. Again, this CF3 has electron withdrawing nature. This CH3 has electron releasing nature. Stability of second one is more than to that of first. NO2 and Cl both has minus I nature, right? This is also minus I, and this is also minus I, right? So both will reduce the stability of free radical. Okay, so both will reduce. So the one which shows strong minus I effect, that will reduce the stability more, and hence the next one, the other one, is more stable. So NO2 shows stronger minus I than Cl. Just the relative strength you have to understand. And the minus I effect or minus I effect of NO2 is more than to that of CN, and hence the stability of this will reduce more. Second one will be more stable. Okay, coming to this example, NO2 has minus I, CH3 has plus I, and O has again minus I. Okay, so if it is A, B and C, right? Plus I will increase the stability, so B is the most stable one, right? Minus I will decrease the stability. NO2, the minus I effect of NO2 is more than to that of NO, because we have one more oxygen atom here. This will reduce the stability more, so after B, the stability of C will be more, and then we have A. B, C, A is the order. NF3, positive charge on this, shows very strong minus I nature. This CH3 plus I, and this also shows minus I. Minus I of NF3 is stronger than to that of fluorine, right? And this is plus I, so the order will be, this is the first one, most stable, and then this will reduce maximum, and then the second stability of order will be this, and third one will be this. Order will be first, second and third. Okay, now you see this carbon atom is sp2 hybridized, and this carbon atom, if you compare, it is sp3 hybridized. Which one is more electronegative? Obviously sp2. This has electron withdrawing nature. Comparatively, it is more electron withdrawing nature, and hence the stability of second one is more than to that of first one. Okay, so this is the few examples we have discussed according to the stability of free radical on the basis of I effect. So far we have discussed the stability of carbocation and free radical with respect to I effect. Okay. Now the third type of intermediate we have, and that is carb anion. Okay. So the third intermediate we have carb anion. Okay. So in this you see, if the carbon atom, if I write down this structure, X, Y, and Z. Okay? And this has one lone pair on it in this p orbital. Okay? Now if you count the number of electrons from carbon here, only carbon I am talking about. This carbon has one electron in this bond, one electron in this bond, one electron in this bond. Right? One electron here. With one extra electron. Right? So total number of electrons if you calculate for carbon, 2, 4, 6, and 8. So it has 8 electrons basically. Right? Number of bond pair and lone pair if I write down, we have 3 bond pair and 1 lone pair. 3 bond pair and 1 lone pair. Okay? So its steric number is 4, right? Hybridization will be sp3. Sp3 hybridization, geometry is what? Geometry is tetrahedral and the shape is trigonal pyramidal. Trigonal pyramidal. Okay? It has how many electrons? 8 electrons. It means complete octet. Right? Complete octet. And because of this, it has one negative charge also present here. Negative charge also present here. One lone pair we have, so we call it as electron rich. May act as nucleophile since it has one unpaired electron. So may act as nucleophile. Nucleophile. May act as what? Lewis base also. Since the lone pair is present, so may behave as a Lewis base. Okay? One last thing here, all the electron pairs are paired, all the electrons are paired, so it is also diamagnetic in nature. Diamagnetic in nature. Okay? Now, the effect of stability due to I effect is exactly opposite to that of carbocation, because in carbocation we have positive charge and here we have negative charge. Okay, so now you see, if I have, I'll write down one example and then we'll conclude the stability of this. So suppose if I write down this CH3 CH2 negative charge. Okay, CH3, CH2, negative charge. CH3, negative charge. CH3, and negative charge. Okay, these are the three examples I have taken to compare its stability, what we have to do, we have to again neutralize this negative charge. Okay, like in case of carbocation, we have discussed and we know the neutral species is more stable than the charged one. Okay, so we have to neutralize this negative charge. To neutralize this negative charge, we have to withdraw electron from this molecule, right? Then only the negative charge density will decrease. So we require what? Minus I group here. What kind of group this we have? It is plus I. So this will release electron. This will also release electron. 2 plus I group we have. And here we have 3 plus I group present. Okay? So obviously the electron density here it will be maximum. And here it will be minimum. So maximum electron density, minimum stability. So order of stability will be what? If it is A, this is B, and this is C. So order of stability will be A will be most stable, then B, then C. This is the order of stability. Okay? So now you see, this is 1 degree carbon ion because this carbon is attached with only one alkyl group. This carbon attached with two alkyl group. So this is 2 degree or secondary carbon ion. And this one is 3 degree or tertiary carbon ion. So stability of carbon ion is what? It is 1 degree will have maximum stability. Then we have 2 degree and then we have 3 degree. This also we can say. 1 degree, 2 degree and 3 degree. Okay. Now one more example I will write down here, which is CH3, CH2, CH2 negative Okay, so all these molecule, if you see, the difference is here only. Yes, fluorine and bromine we have, and we know these halogens has minus I effect, electron withdrawing. Okay, so more a minus I means lesser will be the electron density and more will be the stability. Right, if you can withdraw more electron, the electron density will reduce maximum, right, and hence the stability will increase. So since fluorine has maximum minus I, then chlorine and then bromine, so stability of this A, B and C, if you compare, A will have maximum stability, then B and then C. This is because of minus I. Right? So what we can say, with minus I, if you compare this example and this example, right, this example and this example, if you compare these two, I'll write down here also. CH3, CH2, negative, FCH3, CH2, negative. If you compare these two, this has plus I nature and this has minus I nature. Okay? This will increase electron density, this will decrease electron density. So if it is A, this is B, so stability of B is more than that of A. Okay? And with this example, what we can conclude here, that the stability of carbocation is directly proportional to minus I and inversely proportional to plus I. This is what you have to keep in mind, which is exactly reverse of plus I, right? Reverse of carbocation. In carbocation, stability of carbocation, they have exactly reversed the order we have, which is easily understandable because there we have positive sign and here we have negative sign. See, I have written here Lewis base, right? So this may behave as a Lewis space because a lone pair present on this. Okay, but these are not good Lewis space. Okay, that's another thing. But it may behave or not. Yes, it may behave. Okay, so that's okay. Okay, so we'll see now some examples here. Okay, we'll discuss again few examples on this. I'll write down the examples. You solve it on your own, and then we'll discuss these questions. Okay, you can pause the video and solve. I am explaining it now. First question, you see, we have carbon ion. So this carbon ion is 3 degree. This is 2 degree and this is 1 degree carbon ion. And we know 1 degree carbon ion is most stable among the three. Order will be this. Okay? This carbon atom is sp hybridized. This carbon atom is sp hybridized. sp2. So which one is more more electronegative? sp. This can withdraw more electron, hence the stability will be more. Right? Chlorine has electron withdrawing nature, and fluorine has electron withdrawing nature. If you compare these two, the electron withdrawing nature of this chlorine is more over here in comparison to this, because it is closer, it is at the closest point than this carbocation, from this carbocation. And we know the I effect is a distance dependent effect. More close, more will be the effect of that school, whether it is plus I or minus I. Okay? So since this chlorine is closer to this carbon ion, effect of this chlorine is more here in comparison to this chlorine over here. Right? Hence, this will withdraw more electron, stability order will be this. NF3 plus has a strong, what effect? NO2 has electron withdrawing, minus I, and NF3 have what? Minus I. And which one has minus I effect? Which one has more minus I effect? Tell me. NF3 is a stronger minus I than NO2, right? So this will withdraw more electron, stability order will be this. Okay? Here you see 2 methyl group electron releasing. Increases electron density, stability will decrease. Here we have 2 electron releasing group, withdrawing group, 2 electron withdrawing group. Okay, so if we compare these 3, these are electron releasing, so this has the least stability, so this is at the third position. Right? Fluorine, both has electron withdrawing, fluorine, both has electron withdrawing. But this chlorine is same, and one fluorine and chlorine we have. This chlorine has more electron withdrawing nature, so this will stabilize more. So this is at the first position and this will be at the second position. Okay? CS3 has electron releasing nature. CD3 also has electron releasing nature. CD3 also has electron releasing nature. Which one has, so both all are plus I, so which one has maximum plus I? This CD3 shows max plus I among the three. And CS3 shows minimum plus I among the three. So here the electron density will increase, but that increase will be least among the three. So hence the stability of CS3 will be maximum and CP3 will be minimum. Okay, this carbon atom is again, it is sp hybridized. This is sp2 and this is sp3. Maximum electronegative, pull more electron, maximum stability, then this and this. So this is the stability order of these groups we have done. Okay. So with these examples, you can easily understand how to do these questions on the basis of I effect. Actually, basis of I effect, it is very easy to do all these questions. But when you get the questions in exam, it is not like that in one compound we have only I effect possible. Right? So, it is also possible that in a given compound, with I effect also there are other electronic effects like mesomeric effect, resonance are taking place. Okay? Then you have to be very careful at which effect is dominating. Right? And according to that dominating effect only, the nature of the product will decide. Okay, so this in coming lecture will compare like this also, and we will see that which effect is dominating when, and according to that what should be the nature of the product. Okay, all these things we'll discuss in the coming lecture. So this is all we have discussed, three intermediates and their stability effect order, right? Next we'll see the other application of I effect, which is nothing but acid base acidity and basicity order of the molecule depending on